God is preparing the best of time.
Now her name is Venelaida Johannes. She is standing there to put the devil to shame and to thank God for what he has done for her in her life. On the seventh month, on the first of the seventh month, she was attacked by the evil spirits. Where she was admitted in Ashakati Hospital. Then she went to the X-ray. And they diagnosed that she had a tumor on her liver. And also stones in her bile duct. She received prayers from the apostle, and she was hospitalized to an extent that they wanted to operate her. And when she's talking there now, through the servant of God, she was not operated. And when she went back to the X-ray, what she's saying here is not lies. It's to glorify the name of the Lord God Almighty for what He's doing in her lives. The first paper or the pictures you're looking into now. Is the first X-ray she went to that is showing that they diagnosed that she had a tumor on her liver, and also the bile duct was swollen and there were stones in. And when she was told this by the doctor, she asked the doctor if the tumor on the liver and the stones in the bile duct were curable. And they told her that nothing was curable unless she had to go under operation. They told her that she would go for operation. And when the day arrived, because she knew that she was in the hand of God, and she had been receiving prayers, and she knew that God was able to do all in her life. She told the doctors that before they do the operation, they must take her back to the X-ray. Because when she received the prayers from the apostle declared that the will of God be done. And she knew that whatever the servant of God is telling you, and you have opened your heart, all can be possible. She went back to the X-ray. And when she went back to the X-ray,
hallelujah!
I get to Jesus!
Happen for Jesus Christ beautifully!
That can only be Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. She went back to the X-ray, and there is the answers, or the there is what the doctors found after the second X-ray, that there is no more stones in her bile duct, and even the tumor that was on her liver is no longer there.
Wow, clapping for Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Just imagine coming from an X-ray, and the very first day the doctor diagnosed you, or the machine diagnosed you with that.
No, pefikulo tete o shinokwira mona kucho una inimayo.
And you even She even asked the doctor.
No kwa pula nukuli kwa indo hotola.
That is it possible?
Kuchota shituli kango.
Can this be possible for these things to go out without going through operation?
Kuchangengo tashituli kango ni mayo ipufeme ina shipitila metando.
Is there a different way?
Openambe lonkalo umewayo oloka.
But she said that the doctor said no. Only through operation. And because she has faith, and she said that before you go, you take me for operation. Please take me back to the skin. Because she knows the God that created her. She knows Jesus Christ who died on the cross for her. Everything went well. Clap hand for Jesus Christ. My sister, what is that you couldn't do before?
When
you're going through this situation, that you are able to do it now for the glory of God.
Before she do or she show us what she was unable to do before and what she's able to do now, she just want to tell us that that was not only the paper or what the doctor has done. Because they, after all again, they took some blood test to see if the result that the X-ray was showing was indeed true. And because even the first test was also done through the blood, all the answers just came that there was nothing.
Hallelujah, clap it for Jesus Christ.
And the reason why I don't have my blood test results, they are not allowed to be taken from the medical health passport. Just believe.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you have believed that you will not go for operation, we also believed that everything is done for the glory of God. Can you please tell us or show us what is that you couldn't do before for the glory of God? What I was
unable to do, while I was in the hospital, because I was even unable to lie down straight, she couldn't even breathe in deeply like
that. Grabbing for Jesus Christ.
She couldn't even bend on the side where they were saying that that is a swollen side. She couldn't bend.
Hallelujah! What is that you want to tell us and viewers all over the world? What are your words of encouragement? What
I want to advise all viewers or to the ones that are seated in the church, come close to God, open your heart so that God enters, so that whatever you are going through, God is the one who created you and is the one who can deliver you from all.
Hallelujah. My sister,
amen.
What we want to tell you is this. Jesus Christ loves you.
Yes, Christ ukurole.
And let your faith be made strong every day of your life. Get planted to the rock that Jesus Christ has told Peter that Peter on the rock I'll build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it.
Ometokala mene kwa kepinjo lo mwene Yesus Krista tukucha yoko ta mene kengele kadaadiche no hivelo heli taika findana.
You are blessed.
Oambe kwa.
Hallelujah.